I'm Yolande Poirier from Oracle Technology Network, and I'm here today at JavaLand with Arun Gupta. Arun,
hi.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
So maybe we need to introduce you, but I'm... Well, go ahead.
Sure. Well, I'm Arun Gupta, one of the Java champions. I work for Red Hat, director for developer outreach over there, and a lot of other things.
Okay, and so, and you're also doing DevOps for Kids.
That is right? Correct. So yeah, DevOps for Kids is an initiative where we do STEM workshops all around the world. This initiative was started in Belgium, but I founded the nonprofit. We are a nonprofit registered 501c3 organization in the US. We have a board, and I'm the president of the board. We got several chapters around the US, and so I drive that effort. A lot of fun.
So, is it possible for kids to really learn Java? I mean, why is Java a good programming language for kids?
Yeah, totally. You know, I mean, I've seen a lot of talks where people talk about Java is a very confusing language. Well, if you start with, guess what, public static void main string args, you start teaching kids that as the very first thing, it's going to be confusing. So let's not start that way. I think that's a wrong approach, in my opinion, to start with Java programming. It's very, very important, specifically with kids, to gamify that experience. And in that sense, we are extremely fortunate that Notch, the guy who wrote the game of Minecraft, wrote it using the language of Java. So one of the beauties of the Minecraft game is how you can mod it, and that modding is done using Java. We have very effectively delivered Minecraft modding workshops all around the world over past couple of years now, actually just over 2 years now, and engage with kids who have zero programming experience to be able to actually start writing a little bit of Java code in as little as 6 to 8 weeks. And this is like meeting once a week only for 45 minutes. So been very, very effective. And I think Java is a very fun language. So think about it. In past 20 years, this is the 20th year of Java. In past 20 years, how many languages have come and gone? You know, you don't want to start with Clojure or Scala or any of those languages where the kid itself, you know, looks at the programming language and, oh, I'm never going back to programming. Java is a verbose language, but by intention, because it's meant to be readable not just by computers, but by humans as well. So go back to my example of Minecraft modding. You know, we have done this 8-week workshop, you know, recently completed at an elementary school in Cupertino back in California. This 8-week workshop, we started with kids with zero programming experience, and they were able to write mods in the very first class or some in second class. Wow. Once they're able to write, by the 6th or 7th class, like 45 minutes every week, by 7th class, they were able to read the Java code on what the code is intending to do. Agreed, it is simply written code, but that's the beauty of the language. So I think it's very, very important and very, very fundamental on how you gamify the experience. To me, it's all about leveraging the passion and the excitement around what right. the kids already like and just introducing Java in that way.
And Minecraft is a big one, right?
Oh,
I mean,
God.
They are so motivated by Minecraft. You can ask them to do anything, pretty much, right?
Yeah,
the difficulty is, it doesn't matter.
Literally 2 years ago, when I was still at Oracle at that point of time, we did the very first Minecraft modding workshop literally in my living room. This was a 5-hour long workshop. The concentration of the kids was amazing on how during that entire 5 hours they were glued onto the screen because they wanted to write that one mod, just one simple mod.
Right.
Because they knew that they're learning how to fish and then they can fish on their own.
Right. So that class, tell us a little bit, I mean, what are some of the lessons that you teach in that course that you just built?
Yeah. So the material for that workshop is all available as a bit.ly URL, d4k-minecraft. It's a DevOps for Kids workshop. And as part of that workshop, over 8 weeks, for example, we start with, you know, downloading JDK. When we are introducing JDK to them, we say, hey, by the way, it's just a Blender. You know, because these kids are already playing Minecraft, they know what a jar file is. So we say this Blender is how you produce jar file. You need to write text files, and you put the text files in the Blender, and it gives you a jar file. Why do you have to tell them it compiles it, and then it packages it? You don't have to expose the unnecessary details at that stage. You know, if they face problem, then you get into the details. So we start with JDK. In 45 minutes, they're able to download JDK. They're able to download and install Eclipse. they're able to download and install Forge, which is how we do modding, and there's a sample mod that comes along with it. So in 45 minutes, they're able to download, install, and get their first mod up and running.
Wow.
And then subsequent weeks, we do different mods. For example, in Minecraft, you can chat with other players. So you can say, you type a word potato, and it's going to generate a stack of 64 potatoes for you. And from there, we start, oh, by the way, you type that potato, and you're comparing with potato, that's a string equals method. When you're comparing, it's a string. What is a string? We tell them about string. Then we say, oh, you want to generate a 64 stack. So what is 64? 64 is an integer. So by the way, let's talk about 64, not 128, you know, things like that. And then we say, if you type potato, I want to generate two items. Then we say, oh, by the way, let's add two statements over there. And then we talk about the scope of an if block over there. So just that very simple, fun mod, like, oh, yeah, I want to do that. So you stir their creativity. And then so on, we build on, you know, in about 8 weeks, we write about 4 to 5 mods. And using those mods, we teach them basic Java fundamental concepts. And to me, it was very, very inspirational and very rewarding that, you know, as a Java champion, that I'm building and growing the Java community around the world.
Right, and the next generation, really.
Absolutely. That's well, I want to hire these guys. I want them to work for me, work for us.
Excellent.
Yeah.
You can retire early.
Absolutely. I'm a lazy guy. I just want to sit back and, you know, have these drones running around and do my job. And I think another important part to understand is, you know, in 20 years, Java is the only language, probably the only language, you know, which has stayed so strong. When your kids grow out, the Java is going to be only stronger. So also look from the career perspective. When you want to get out, you don't want to work in a language which may not even exist like in 5-10 years. So Java has always stayed there as a mainstream language. It will stay as a mainstream language in the years to come. So a lot to stick around.
Right, and it's they can do a lot also with Java, right? I mean, they can code on devices, they can do backend. I mean, it's...
You name the device, you know, whether it's desktop, whether it's mobile,
exactly.
Whether it's phone, you know, it's all there, everywhere, embedded, you name it. You know, Java is everywhere in that sense.
Right.
Yeah.
So anything else people should know? I mean, when is your... What kind of information can people find?
Yeah. Well, you can find out about the DevOps for Kids initiative on... we have a website, usa.devoxforkids.org. You can find out over there. You can learn more about our workshops on meetup.com/DevOps for Kids-Bay Area. That's where we run the San Francisco Bay Area meetup. The Minecraft modding workshop that I talked about particularly is a bit.ly URL. It's bit.ly/d4k-Minecraft. Shoot us a mail, info@devoxforkids.org.
Great. Thank you and great work. So thank you for all your effort.
Thank you, Yolan.
Thanks.